Okay, so now we're going to get into some serious stuff. We're going to look at roles and responsibilities, which is very, very important, because then you'll see sometimes you expect it as a tutor, this is my role, and then you get your tutor coordinator and your lecturer and your students asking you to do other things which you think is not part of your role. So we're going to do the next activity, which actually, let's see what you think your roles are before we actually go into roles and responsibilities. All of you have one.
What's your name?
Okay, what would you as a tutor consider your role and responsibilities to be? You can just put it in point form. How would you describe a good tutor? Some of you would have had tutors in the past, so you could draw on that. If you did not have tutors, then what do you think a good tutor should be? And then how would you describe a bad tutor? About 3 bullets, 4 bullets under each is fine. Oh, okay. So they'll have all the answers. Some responses. What would you as a tutor consider your role and responsibilities to be? Yes.
The tutor should be knowledgeable and informative. She should be always on top with the content of what he's going to talk about.
Yes, really good. Was that given last week?
That's a peaceful answer.
2 out of 2, very good. Okay. A tutor should be knowledgeable, yes.
Motivational teacher, facilitator, mediator, responsible to the students, to help them, to inform them, to be the best students they can be, but not their friends, but the senior academic colleague.
Okay, that's a PhD answer. Okay. Good. Anyone else wants to do roles and responsibilities?
I'm going to do a great one. A basically lecture content in terms of the final project that so it is again.
Yes. So you're not the same as your lecturer lecturing, so you're actually breaking it down.
The Vada platform that allows students to speak their ideas and negotiate.
Yes, that's very important.
Distinguish between having knowledge and understanding the knowledge.
Yes, yeah. And you guys as teachers will be able to do that. That's good. Let's look at the second one. How would you describe a good tutor? How many of you had tutors in the past years that you were here? All of you. Okay. So how would you describe a good tutor?
For me, a tutor in the first place must be passionate.
Good.
This is the engine that will keep you warm. He must be, or she must be, patient, because you are dealing with human beings. So you must have this quality, flexible, approachable. So the students mustn't feel like there are that barrier that they can't find it difficult to communicate with you. Confident, helpful. You are there to help the students. Good listener, because you must listen to these students. They value them as a human beings. Work as a mediator, facilitator, but not as a dominator. And consider, and the last thing is to be competitive.
I don't think she made it.
Another PhD.
So,
yeah, the PhD.
sentence of that.
Great answers. Okay, so is there anything else we can add to being a good tutor that wasn't said already?
Being a good presenter.
Yes, a good presenter.
Communicates effectively.
Communicates effectively.
Always punctual.
Always punctual. Very good. Flexible.
I say not biased, because at the end of the day we have
yes.
One relationship students coming from different backgrounds and
yes.
We can't because our opinions or our company or even maybe on someone else. We need to understand that all the students in the class have different opinions and we need to take that and make them put a proper argument from that and not just give our views or our.
Very good. It's about being inclusive. That's very yes.
Lead by example, do what you expect the students to do.
Yes, that's very important. A lot of the time our lecturers tell us a whole lot of things and they don't even follow that, but yet they want us to do it. So you have to be a good role model for your students. Let's look at bad tutor. I'm sure...
Yeah,
okay. Oh,
no, it's just in relation to what she said. I feel like we should say goals for ourselves that we need to meet and goals for our students. So we always have that level of achievement that we need to reach all the time. So that can be a sense of motivation for them.
Yes. Short-term goals, small goals, that's achievable at each stage and then kind of build all the time. Right? Sometimes you give goals that are unreachable and that frustrates the students, frustrates you as well. Bad tutor?
Yeah, I hope you don't mind, but I think I broke there. The above mentioned list is too long to go to my list. So the opposite of that list.
Okay, see, that's the great R answer. Anyone experience a bad tutor? Everything opposite is sick. Not punctual, not flexible, not inclusive.
But then some walk in with that, you know, I'm your tutor,
yes.
I'm doing English, I'm doing Boston,
yes.
So I'm like, okay, so
yes.
Can I speak to you quietly? So there's a fine line, basically, of being confident, but
yes.
You shouldn't be, you know, overconfident, arrogant, and rude. But you should give that platform where students can actually come to you and speak to you whenever they feel.
And you see, like she says, it's that fine line which makes it very difficult. Should you be friendly? And would they take you as being over-friendly and then try to be your pal and want to go out for a drink and they want you to do a homework and assignment for them? Where do you draw the line? Okay. So I see most of you don't have bad tutor experiences. So